Book of Limbo was essentially a kind of physicalization, like an artifact of the experience of the internet. The feeling you get with the internet, the sense of going in a wormhole and diving into this kind of virtual universe, what would that be if it was something physical? Some of it was full CG, some of it was photographs, some was paper sculpture or pure typography. It was just about having this really rich tapestry of different techniques and ideas.
We built a few things in front of the camera in studio. There's some shots in there of koi, you know, the Japanese fish. There's a recipe in there where we pulled out a lot of spices and ingredients from my kitchen.
There's a glass of whale milk, which was actually
hand milk. That was a bit risky that day when I was swimming up.
Yes,
it's toothpaste. We used a lot of GAN. GAN stands for Generative Adversarial Network.
What is that, Corey?
What is that?
Please explain what that number means.
Okay. So what it is that it's two computer systems fighting each other, and so trying to trick the other computer system. And this other system is trying to pick out the mistakes of the other.
We use it for different things, and we use it for everything from just taking tiny thumbnails and enlarging them, which is more practical things, to just creating completely fictitious scenes and imagery where it was sort of about the serendipitous outcome that we wanted to reach by adding certain ingredients and landing on a particular thing. When you're setting out to make any book, there's a natural resource commitment. Print manufacturing was done locally, source things that were high post-consumer waste content. They were nice, valuable artifacts, and so that quality was also important. It was something that felt really valuable and ownable. We do get a lot of quite strange briefs. This is probably up there with them, which is great. And, you know, credit to Belong for just getting this sort of idea across the line. So it was a very unique project to get involved in.